يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَذَرُوا مَا بَقِيَ مِنَ الرِّبَا إِن كُنتُم مُّؤْمِنِينَ فَإِن لَّمْ تَفْعَلُوا فَأْذَنُوا بِحَرْبٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ
making you money when you're sleeping and when you're awake, right? It's this passive income that's supposed money made from money itself. And the essential, you know, there's actually an old book, and it's basically a thesis he wrote on the effects of riba on a society and how banks will eventually go bust and houses will collapse because mortgages are happening. And then and jobs will be lost, and this entire bubble that's built by riba will collapse. It was written in the 60s in India. That's kind of pretty good foresight, because that's what riba does and is doing, you know? They stand on nothing. They have no basis. لا يقومون, they don't stand, meaning you don't see them around. That's the figurative meaning. Those who consume riba, you don't see them around. They don't stand. إلا كما يقوم الذي يتخبطه الشيطان من المس. Except just like the one who stands around that has been touched by, or has been taken by the shaitan, grabbed by the shaitan with a touch. In other words, the devil has touched someone was an expression that someone's gone crazy. Someone's wild, their hair's all over the place, their disheveled clothes, and they're running crazy in the street. تخبطه الشيطان من المس. That was the expression. Allah says people who consume riba are that crazy. Dignified, educated people turning into crazy wild animals. Shaitan has got, it's like shaitan has touched them. Also, this implies you can't reason with them anymore. When they start tasting that kind of lifestyle of riba, then there's no reasoning with them. They go crazy. And then, and how crazy do they get? Well, they say, ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّهُمْ قَالُوا إِنَّمَا الْبَيْعُ مِثْلُ الرِّبَى. That is because they say, بَيْعُ is just like riba. Trade, business which Allah made halal, is just like riba. What's the difference? I rent a house, I pay the same money. I mortgage a house, I pay the same money. What's the difference? Financially, the same amount of money left my pocket. What difference does it make? And so they'll argue, إِنَّمَا الْبَيْعُ مِثْلُ الرِّبَى. And so the new argument is, hey, you're going to go become a doctor. Take the loan. You're going to save lives. It's a good thing. You're doing an ibadah for, I even heard this. You're doing an ibadah for the sake of Allah. Go take the riba loan. I mean, just think about it in very layman's terms. I'm not a financial analyst. I'm a very layman person in finance. Just think of it in very basic, primitive terms. You got a house in New York in 1820. You paid $10,000 for that house. Or better yet, you paid a brick of gold for that house. A brick of gold you paid for that house. Now you own that house, right? And you bought it on interest, of course. So you're supposed to make payments of 10,000 over a course of 20 years. How much did you end up paying? 25,000. Now come times for you to sell that same house. You're going to sell it for 11,000, 12,000, make a little profit. What are you going to sell it for? Well, you spent 25, so you should at least ask for 30. The next guy buys it for 30. He's going to take another 30 years to pay it off. How much did he pay? He paid 60. He's going to sell it. He's going to sell it at least for 70. The next guy buys the same house, same brick, same foundation, same patch of land, same physical material value. But the next generation and the next generation and the next generation, it becomes more and more and more and more difficult for them to afford the same thing. The same exact thing becomes more and more and more difficult for them to afford. And perhaps even the previous generation died paying it off, paying 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 times the price of what it was actually worth, and left their children in debt or homeless. Those generations got robbed of that wealth. People got robbed of that wealth. That's what riba does. That's what riba, it robs people of value, of good hard-earned money. Our fellow American citizens, and now all of a sudden within a month, their mortgage payment went from $1,500 to $3,500. They can't afford it anymore. And so now they're paying for a house that's worth $200,000. They're paying $600,000-$700,000. And they can't. So they're kicked out of their house. And then the bank sells it off. Oh, at a loss of $300,000. Oh, poor bank. Only got to make $100,000 this time. you know, that's riba. That's how riba is eating away at not just us, all of society. It's a means of oppression in society.
تكلم والشجرة مني سيف الهم تراه استل سيف الهم تراه استل.